The Antarctic Ice Sheet is the huge mass of ice located at the South Pole, covering the entire continent we call Antarctica. Around the edges of this ice sheet, some of the ice floats on top of the ocean, forming large platforms called ice shelves. The Antarctic Ice Sheet is vast, covering nearly 14 million square kilometers. That's almost 1.5 times the size of Europe. If it melted entirely, it would raise global sea levels by nearly 60 meters. But despite the fact that Antarctica is extremely cold, satellite measurements tell us that parts of the ice sheet are melting at an ever-increasing rate. Most of this melting occurs beneath the ice shelves, driven by relatively warm ocean waters. This causes the inland ice to flow faster and lose more and more of that ice to the ocean. And it's this ice loss from inland that leads to sea levels rising. The grounding line is a boundary that marks the transition between the ice that is grounded on land and the ice that has started to float in an ice shelf. The grounding line is a key indicator of the health of the ice sheet. If the snowfall inland is balanced with the ice that flows over the grounding line, then the grounding line will stay where it is. If ice loss from inland is so large that it outweighs the snowfall, then the grounding line will retreat inland. Ice loss from Antarctica could increase suddenly due to a mechanism called marine ice sheet instability, an event in which the grounding line crosses a tipping point, beyond which ice loss suddenly increases, and grounding lines retreat inland at an unstoppable rate, a point of no return. If grounding lines were to cross this tipping point in West Antarctica, for example, the ice loss could eventually cause sea levels to rise up to 3 meters. Observations from the last few decades show that many grounding lines are retreating. This retreat could be caused by two different things. Either the warm ocean waters are melting the ice and giving the grounding lines a push inland, or it could be the marine ice sheet instability. TiPACCs is an EU-funded research project which looks into tipping points in the ice and ocean of Antarctica. And we have been working to determine exactly what is causing the grounding line to retreat. To do so, we use computer modeling. Our models simulate the behavior of the real-world Antarctic ice sheet using mathematical equations. Following a common method to test for instability, we imagine the position of a grounding line as a ball resting in a valley. If we artificially warm the ocean waters in our models, we can give the grounding line a little push away from its start point. Then we look at what the grounding lines do during our model experiments. If they continue to retreat when we stop pushing them, then the instability has already begun and the ball rolls out of the valley. But if they return to where they started, the ball will roll back, and it means that the instability is not taking place. Our computer models show that, as it stands, the grounding lines return back to their start position after we stop pushing them, meaning there is most likely no instability at play in Antarctica today. In short, this is good news, as it means the current retreat of the ice is only being caused by the ocean. But where could the warm ocean waters of today eventually push the grounding lines to? And could they be pushed so far that they eventually cross a tipping point and begin an unstoppable retreat? To find out, we did another ice sheet model experiment. This time, we give the grounding lines the same push that the ocean is giving them today. Then, we run the model for a very long time into the future, to see if an instability eventually occurs under these conditions. In some areas of the ice sheet, we find that this instability could occur, and the grounding lines do retreat. For example, at Thwaites Glacier, one of the biggest glaciers in West Antarctica, our experiments show that the warm ocean temperatures around Antarctica right now could eventually cause the grounding line to move very far inland. Even when we make the ocean cold again, the ice cannot return to its initial position. The retreat of Thwaites Glacier would cause a large amount of ice to be lost from the region. Over hundreds to thousands of years, this would raise sea levels by several meters and have devastating impacts on coastal populations, ecosystems, and economies around the world. But remember, although unstoppable grounding line retreat and sea level rise may occur if global warming is not reduced, it is not inevitable yet. There is still time to stop it. If the marine ice sheet instability is triggered, it would take a very long time for ice loss and sea level rise to unfold. Reducing greenhouse gas emissions will help to slow down or even prevent it from happening entirely. But the time to act is now. To find out more, visit our website and Twitter page.